We started out this season by seeing over 103,000 people. And now we're down to 72. If they get caught, it was all for nothing. So far, this week has been exhilarating.
You, I can believe, is a recording artist.
And packed with drama.
I'm not arguing with you because that's what you want.
Oof. I hated my group so much.
But for those who survived, today is all that matters. The contestants will perform by themselves with a band, backup singers, and if they choose, instruments.
Here we are, the last day of Hollywood Week. These contestants have worked so hard all week to make it to the next round of the competition. This is Do or Die, their last chance to make an impression with the judges.
The best will move on. Yeah. But not everyone can take the pressure. And by the end of the day, the contestants will be divided. And it will be a yes.
You guys are through!
Or a no.
It's the end of the road. You guys didn't make it.
The pressure is the highest it's been all week. The stakes are even higher. This is American Idol. In Hollywood, California. And it's day four of a long and grueling hell week. Our location is the historic Kodak Theater. The perfect place for the contestants to make their last stand. After a long day of solos, 72 contestants have now been moved to a holding area outside the theater. They're now waiting to find out if what they've done earlier in the day was enough to keep them around, or if it will get them sent back to their everyday lives.
You can't be sure about anything right now, because, I mean, everyone here is amazing.
Pretty scary right now. No one really knows what's going to happen. Now it's in the hands of the judges.
And inside the theater, the judges are making their final decisions.
Just start off with number one. Just put him in the middle there, darling. Thank you.
Yes.
No.
I've got a maybe.
Yes.
Chris Chatham. Ariana, if it's not three yeses, it goes in. No. Right, he's in the maybe pile. Put him in, please.
I think we need to revisit him.
What? Yes.
Yes. Okay, keep him in.
And after the decisions are made, the contestants will be split up into four different rooms. It's 7 p.m. And back in the main holding room, the contestants are still waiting. And with their earlier auditions being their last chance to make a good impression, they have a lot to think about.
To start off with number one.
Going back to the beginning of the day, it started off like any other day in Hollywood Week, early.
We're here.
And the contestants got right down to business with last-minute rehearsals to make sure everything was right for their big moment on stage.
Just a tad bit slower. Just like drag it.
Okay, try it again. Two.
So after choosing the order of the day.
Oh, yeah. Ooh. I got number one.
It was into the theater, and it was time to get things started.
Here's how it's going to work today. All 72 singers will take the stage, and you can see we've got Michael at the piano, backup singers. Basically, they got their own band on stage. If they choose, they can even play their own instrument. Now, after the song, there will be no judges' comments, no results. We'll have to wait until the end of the day for the brutal and final cuts.
And drawing lucky number one was Adam Lambert. In his first Hollywood audition, the judges gave him mixed reviews.
Adam, I'm feeling like you're still doing music theater.
I disagree completely. Look at every single artist that defined themselves as someone unique and different, and you are that package.
The reason why I want to be on the show is because I want to, like, take a song that we've heard a million times and kind of, like, twist it, make it
good.
I can't.
Today, he's putting his theory to the test with his song choice.
It's Believe by Cher.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. But I won't do disco, I promise.
Okay, all right.
I promise.
So you're out to win them over, all right.
Yeah.
And after all that's said and done, you're gonna be the lonely one. Oh, do you believe in love after love?
Adam's risky song choice seemed to strike a chord with the judges. And hoping to do the same was Matt Gerard, the dueling piano player who first impressed the judges in Louisville.
You remind me of Elliot from season 5. You could be great.
He's fought his way through the week's competition, and today he's able to play the keyboard during his solo.
Well, I said Georgia, baby, home. No peace, I find. Yeah, just a low, sweet song. Yeah, keeps Georgia on my mind. To know, sweet song, yeah, keeps Georgia on my mind.
Yeah. That was fun.
Yeah.
So I've just been waiting for so long to play for them. It's awesome.
It's 7:45 p.m., and in the main holding room, Matt and 71 other contestants still wait to see if their earlier auditions were enough to get them through. And the tension is getting to best friends Danny Gokey and Jamar Rogers.
I'm a mess. I'm really ready for this to be over.
The two have made quite an impression on the judges all week, but how did they do during their solos earlier in the day? Jamar went first as Danny watched from the wings.
Hey there, Delilah, don't you worry about the distance. I'll be there when you get lonely. Give this song another listen. Close your eyes. I'll be there to my size. I'm by your side. Oh, it's what you do to me. 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 What you do to me.
Yeah.
Woo! Thank you.
Very nice. Very nice.
I'm just really hard on myself. I think I could have did it better.
Are you kidding
me? Yeah, no. But you know what? It's over. The crowd loved it. And I got Kara and Paula to smile at me. So.
What I heard was, it was amazing. It really was.
He's got to say that. He's my guy.
Then it was Danny's turn.
I hope you never lose your sense of wonder. And you get your fill to eat, but you keep that hunger. May you never take one single breath for granted. God forbid love ever leave you empty-handed. I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. And when one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And if you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. Yeah, oh,
yeah. Good one.
Woo! Coming up, who will make it past the judges' cuts? This is where the drama begins.
You couldn't have talked to me about this afterwards?
Tatiana, can you come here, please?
Find out who rises to the occasion and who falls under the pressure.
Can I start over? I'm sorry.
Welcome back. It's 8 p.m. at the Kodak Theater, where the judges continue deliberations. And the contestants are waiting for those decisions back in the main holding room. Earlier today, they were all given one last chance to battle it out on stage. So far, the guys have been impressive, and the male talent remains strong. With Kansas City auditioner, Anoop Desai.
Some ask me questions,
Why am I so real? But they don't understand me. They really don't know the deal about a brother. It's my prerogative.
The talent continued with Puerto Rico native Jorge Nunez. But for Scott McIntyre, this audition has finally given him a chance to be where he's most comfortable, behind his piano. We first met Scott in Phoenix, where we were moved by his story and wowed by his voice.
And this is why my eyes are closed. It's just as well for all I've seen.
We're gonna need to see you with a piano to see how great you can be.
Scott? You got four yeses.
And today, Scott gets to show them just how good he can be.
Oh, I'm going home to the place where I belong, where your love has always been enough for me, where these faces and these places are getting old. So I'm going.
I just found out Paula gave me a standing ovation. I didn't see that. And that means that I had the absolute greatest time of my life out there.
The first girl of the day was Kendall Beard. The Texas native first impressed the judges with her bubbly personality at the Puerto Rico auditions.
Kendall, four yeses.
Yeah!
True to Hollywood, girl. True to Hollywood.
How'd you go? So we're in Puerto Rico, and the first person we put through is a blonde Texan.
Happy dance, happy dance. This is my happy dance.
But she had a shaky start in Hollywood.
I thought you were this young, vibrant, light girl, and today you're dressed in black like it's a funeral.
Now she has one last chance to show the judges why she's here.
Took my key into the side of his pretty little suit, a four-wheel drive, carved my name into his leather seat.
Also hoping they did enough to impress the judges is 16-year-old Stevie Wright.
I think that if I just stay positive and I focus on what I'm supposed to be doing, I think that I'll be okay.
They start in my toes, make me crinkle my nose. Wherever it goes, I always know.
And mother of three, Lil Rounds.
I'm not gonna be defeated. My family's not gonna be defeated. This is gonna be good for us.
Also not ready to be defeated is Kristen McNamara.
You've remained pretty calm in the midst of a lot of drama.
Yes.
So you don't want this. You want to rest your voice. So I don't care if you cry.
They have my dream in their hands, and that's very scary.
Why didn't you let Nancy get to you?
My mom always told me that loose lips sink ships.
Oof. Oof. What if I told you she's behind you right now? Because we're doing another interview with her and wanted to say she's sorry. Nancy? Kidding.
That was a lie. My heart stopped.
Kidding.
Ryan!
Because of you, I don't know how to let anyone else. Because of you, I'm ashamed of my life. Cause it's empty. Because of you.
Backstage is Misha Vanna Henson. We first met Misha Vanna with her family last year in San Diego.
Well, my family's always supported me singing every time we have a get-together. They all try to get me to sing for them. They usually get a song or two out of me.
Welcome to Hollywood!
But her Hollywood journey was short-lived.
I made it to the second day of Hollywood Week, and then I got cut. So I'm back this year with a vengeance.
And in this crazy life, and in these crazy times, it's you, your every word, you're in me now, your every line, your everything.
I feel like I really performed it, so hopefully they like it.
But Misha Vanna knows better than anyone else that nothing in Hollywood is guaranteed. It's now 8:30, and as the judges continue to deliberate, they've already decided one group's fate. And they're now going to be moved to the first of four separate holding rooms, where they will sit and continue to wait for the judges to make their decisions public.
Like, everyone in this group really did some really cool performances tonight, so I'm hoping that means a good thing that we're in here.
Coming up, Tatiana gets one more shot.
No, none of that today.
Tatiana?
Will it be enough?
Tatiana, can you come here, please?
They made it this far. Who will go the distance and who will fall short?
Can I start over? I'm sorry.
Welcome back to Hollywood Week. It is 8:45 p.m. and the judges have finished deliberations for another 18 contestants. Group 2's names are being called and they're being moved into the second of four holding rooms. Ricky Bratty, Michael Sarver, Alex Wagner-Trugman, and Tatiana Nicole Del Toro. Throughout the competition, Tatiana has taken every opportunity to show the judges her expansive repertoire.
That I'll leave you if I could.
Okay. You shouldn't have done that song.
Whatever you want from me, I'm giving you everything.
In that dress, for sure.
The night I looked at you.
It was horrible.
I was born on the water.
Tatiana, what's going to happen?
I want a Sunday kind
of No, come on.
I love to last.
Tatiana, I don't know what to say.
Oh, unknown. My suffer keeps moving like a rolling stone. Now that I see you in her arms, I want you back. I want to get through.
No, none of that today.
But earlier today, she only got one song to impress the judges.
From the moment I saw you, I went out of my mind. You got a way that you're making me feel. I can feel I can do anything.
So Tatiana leaves the stage confident. Three others in her room who should also be happy with their performances are Alexis Grace.
Then I dug my key into the side of his pretty little souped up four-wheel drive.
Kenny Hoffpower.
Oh, well, there's no need to complicate. Oh, our time is short.
And Jasmine Murray.
You're still a part of everything I do. You're on my heart just like a tattoo.
Thank you.
These contestants are now sitting in room 2, where Nathaniel Marshall is having a tough time settling in as he remembers the drama of the week.
I tried my hardest. I don't know what to do.
Did a thing twice. Your chain of thought may be altered. So if you must fall to be wise, your mind's in Disturbia.
I'm not trying to start drama with anyone.
Disturbia.
And it's not just your dream at stake.
Okay,
here.
Listen.
Disturbia.
You can talk to me about this afterwards.
How did we know we were going to hate each other?
Can he leave that drama behind? Or will it influence the judge's decision? The week has taken its toll on Joanna Pacitti as well. Her entire idol journey has been an emotional one.
I think you're worthy.
I'm jumping out of this, baby.
It's okay.
Oh, my God.
I get emotional. And even if they're saying good things or bad things, I just get, like, my legs start shaking.
And on the final day, her nerves won the battle, and the result was a disaster. But Joanna wasn't the only one in her room to struggle with lyrics. Casey Carlson messed up, too.
Live every second like you're a tattoo.
confident that lyrics would not be his problem, Stephen Fowler was up all night rehearsing his overall performance.
This song is not hard to memorize. It might be hard to deliver or whatever, but it's not wordy. It's not lyrically tongue-twisting.
I couldn't see it until I let go and gave in to loving. Feel the world turning around and I'm giving this moment.
Can I start over? I'm sorry.
Waiting.
That happened once during a live telecast with Brooke White. She actually asked to start over on live television. This time, the judges granted him a second chance and see how he does.
On the horizon, but I couldn't see it, so I gave in the love.
Too bad. Too bad. Aww.
Now they all sit in the same room awaiting their mutual fate. Together, they'll stay in Hollywood, or together, they'll be going home.
A lot of girls.
A lot of girls.
The judges are close to finalizing another group, but the numbers are wrong, and they have to make an adjustment.
We want to even it out, really, don't we?
Yeah, right, so we really obviously need to...
Take some... I think we should take...
Oh, wait.
Tatiana?
Tatiana, come here.
Coming up, how will the future change for this oil rig worker and welder? Plus, it's decision time for Nick. Or is it Norman?
I don't know what to do. Maybe I need to, like, get serious and go and sing on Friday as myself. Maybe Norman's done.
And the judges.
This is so hard for us to do.
Welcome back to the final day of Hollywood Week. It's 9 p.m. The judges have been deliberating for hours. After making some progress, they've moved half the contestants into two separate rooms. Their fate has been decided, but they won't know the outcome until the judges have decided on the rest of our contestants, including Tatiana. Before the break, she was removed from room two. Now the judges are reconsidering her and trying to reach a conclusion on the contestants waiting in the main holding area. One of whom is Nick Mitchell, a.k.a. Norman Gentle.
The best man.
On the first day, Nick performed as his alter ego.
There's no way I could ever, ever come.
But on group day, Nick tried to be himself and still wasn't taken seriously.
It was atrocious. And I think that you, I'm not even going to try and remember what your name is because you've got so many, you've kind of influenced it to be a joke.
Just trying to entertain.
It looked like a lose-lose situation.
I don't know what to do. Maybe I need to, like, get serious and go and sing on Friday as myself. I don't know. Maybe Norman's done.
So which persona would he choose for his final performance?
I can't make guarantees. It's always impulsive. 5 minutes before, we'll know.
In the end, it was Norman Gentle who took the stage.
We're gonna go kind of slow, right?
Love. I love him.
Georgia. Georgia, no peace inside. You're just an old sweet song on my mind.
So have Norman Gentle's theatrics overshadowed Nick Mitchell's voice?
Yeah,
girls.
She's
Let's
good.
Put the youngest in. She's 16. Let's put her back in.
Back in the theater after hundreds of performances and hours of careful contemplation.
40, 44.
It all comes down to this one moment.
That's the magic number.
That's the number.
Yes. Woo! Yes.
The judges have made their decisions on the remaining 38 contestants. And they've been split up into two different groups. In room three is Lanisha Young, an early favorite from the Louisville auditions. And in room four is Nick Mitchell. As the waiting continues, some can't help but wonder if being in the same room as Nick is a good thing. And next to him is Anne-Marie Boscovich. She's wondering if she played it too safe.
Is everyone singing I Hope You Dance?
After seeing so many others on day four perform the same song,
still feel small
when you stay on this side of the ocean.
Did Anne-Marie still stand out?
Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. I hope you dance. I hope you dance.
Someone else that needs to stand out is Juno Joyner. He's been flying under the radar in Hollywood, but making it through each round. Today's performance could be make or break.
Hey there, Delilah, what's it like in New York City? I'm 1,000 miles away, but...
And it was in New York City when we first met, Juno.
I think you got a good voice. I just don't know about the whole star persona.
The judges were unsure at first, but it was Juno's son that helped sway the decision.
Oh my God, you have to say yes.
Yes, you threw it out of your baby.
Oh, is what you do to me.
Juno's still hoping his stay won't be cut short. And to add to the tension, the judges have decided that room four is the room that Tatiana will join. Her sudden arrival has everyone feeling anxious. Now all of them are second-guessing today's performances. Tatiana's new group is as nervous as ever.
I don't know what's going on.
Coming up, the agony continues.
They're secretly going to be right there. I just forgot their lyric.
And they stood out in the early rounds. But have the judges found new favorites? Plus, the verdict.
We've done it.
So now what?
I'm sorry, sweetheart.
It's 9:30 p.m. here at the Kodak Theater. The judges have spent hours deliberating. All four of the holding rooms have been filled. Now, all the contestants are feeling the stress from the week and the magnitude of what the judge's decision will mean to each of them. In room three are two Louisville favorites, Lanisha Young and Kaylin Lloyd. Kaylin's earlier audition has been weighing on her all day.
Some people want it all, but I don't want nothing at all.
After Simon ended her song, Kaylin had little to say afterwards, and she was visibly upset. Next up on the stage was a confident Lanisha Young. Lanisha stole the hearts of America at the Louisville auditions, not only with her voice, but with her story.
Life hasn't always been easy for me and my siblings. We were raised with nothing, and homeless.
I think you could do really well in this competition. I think you're kind of what we need.
You better run. You got
to Hollywood, baby!
Hollywood seemed like the opportunity she's been waiting for. And everything was riding on her last solo performance.
I can't let this go. I can't mess this up for nothing. Nothing.
I'm not gonna write you a love song, 'cause you asked for it, 'cause you need one. And you see, I'm not gonna write you a love song, 'cause you tell me it make a break in it.
And although Lanisha felt good about her performance, the hours of waiting have caused doubt to set in. And waiting down the hall in room number 2 is Kai Kalama. He can't help but wonder about his chances after today's earlier audition. His voice was feeling the effects of a rigorous Hollywood week.
We are undercover running on the sun.
And it showed in his performance.
Up on the sun.
My voice is definitely not what it was a few days ago.
Also in Kai's room is Michael Sarver. We first met this oil rig roughneck at the Phoenix auditions.
I'm gonna love you more than...
He's had a great run in Hollywood Week so far.
One of the best I heard today, dude. Very, very nice. Even better than when we first saw you for me.
And the leads were weird, man. Thank God Michael
Thank
was in
God.
Your group.
And today, there was one thing weighing on his mind as he took the stage.
American Idol means so much because it can make a difference for our family and for our future.
When you reach the bottom, it's now or never. Is it all, or are we just friends? If this is how it ends, with a simple telephone call, you leave me here with nothing at all.
Although Michael feels good about his performance, others in the room are not so sure about theirs. Back in the theater, the judges have made their final decision.
Okay, bye,
good
guys.
Stuff. Have a safe trip. Fine.
But Simon has to catch a flight back to London and leaves the job of breaking the news to Randy, Paula, and Kara.
Bye, everyone. Now, the judges are on their way over to deliver the final verdict for Hollywood Week. And if you think about the contestants, they've been operating on about 2 hours of sleep a night. So they're exhausted, they're anxious, they're ready to find out if they've made it to the next round.
And as the moment of truth arrives, in room number 2, Nathaniel Marshall was trying to figure out if the odds were in his favor.
I don't know if there's like really good people that like impress the judges like crazy, and there's people that just forgot their lyrics to the point that like they have to stop playing and walk off stage.
It's been a long wait, and the time has come for room 2's decision.
Hey everyone.
Hey guys.
Hello.
Some of you start out so strong. So strong, and then it's hard being judged on when you have groups, and I know that.
It's just the performances were so sporadic.
We get caught up in, I do, dancing and hearing what I think I'm hearing, and then we listen back, and it's not.
It's just not as good as it was.
I'm sorry.
Among the lucky few who made it through in this room are Alexis Grace, Joanna Pacitti, and Casey Carlson. Kai Kalama, Ariana Afsar, Jasmine Murray, Stephen Fowler, Nathaniel Marshall, and Michael Sarver. While they all continue to celebrate the good news, the contestants next door in Lanisha Young's room can't help but overhear them.
Well, they got three.
And India Morrison is left to think about her Hollywood Week experience.
Oh, baby, give me one more chance.
India has more than sung her way through this competition.
I might have got the words, but it's oh so cool because we oh so tight and we oh so smooth. Hey!
Her unique style even helped save her group.
India, you were the glue there. I mean, seriously, I mean, you gave these guys soul. It was just, it was very, very clever what you just did.
But will a good group performance be enough after a trying solo audition?
All my eyes in my head, don't want to think about it. I'm just going insane, yeah, yeah.
Now India and the others in her group are about to find out.
Hey, everyone.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
These are the toughest decisions that we have to make. It's hard for us because, you know, we look at everything that you guys do during the whole week.
And it becomes a very difficult task.
Yes.
So, guys, let me break it down for you. It's the end of the road. You guys didn't make it.
So the dream is over for Michael Castro, India Morrison, Kaylin Lloyd, and Lanisha Young. And even in Lanisha's great disappointment, she's holding on to what her idol journey has taught her.
I learned that you have to be humble and work hard for what you want in life.
I appreciate everything you done did. I appreciate you singing to me.
This is a miracle, so I'm glad I made it this far.
When we come back, two more rooms await their fate. Will your favorites survive?
This has been the toughest decision this season.
Yes.
So this is a no, right?
After the break. Welcome back to the last day of Hollywood Week. It's 10 p.m. Earlier today, our remaining contestants had one last chance to prove that their worth and talent was enough to see them through to the next round of the competition. This last performance comes on the heels of the toughest week of their lives. And after a week of vocal and emotional torture, the contestants are left fatigued and ready to find out what fate will bring. The judges' results are in. One group has been given good news and their journey will continue. And another group has been given bad news, and it's the end of the road. But there are still two groups remaining, longing to know what lies in their future. The promise of stardom or the agony of defeat. Room 1 has been waiting the longest. They were the first group to be placed. But their long wait is over. It's decision time.
How you guys feeling? This has been the toughest decision for us to make this season. We always encourage people to come back and to, right, you know, everything, you know, because, I mean, you guys got a shot, you know, you're really young. But I'm just looking at all these faces, this is so hard for us to do. I mean, you know, you can only imagine. You guys are through!
Along with Anoop and Scott, it's good news for Danny Gokey and Jamar Rogers, Adam Lambert, Lil Rounds, Jorge Nunez, and Jackie Tone. And they can all breathe a big sigh of relief. For the final room, hearing another set of cheers ignites an uneasy feeling as their chances of continuing have just become slimmer.
Two rooms that scream?
Yeah.
So when you hear two rooms scream, what does that mean?
It means their room is next. And the looming tension and uncertainty is increased with the late addition of Tatiana Del Toro.
I mean, you know, and these have been the last 2 days have just been treacherous, been so hard.
And I know that you guys have brought everything that you could and then some. I know how hard it is to get there.
Yeah, you should be thankful at least for that. I mean, you know, because, I mean, you know, we put you guys through it these last days.
It's okay. So. It's okay, honey. Don't.
You know what? It's one audition, but it's one audition that will leave a lasting memory, I'm certain.
And you guys did the best you could, right?
Yeah, and it's been tough.
You did the best you could.
We raised the bar every season higher, and this is season 8. It's tougher than ever for us, so, and for you guys
as
well.
You're making it harder than it is, sweetheart.
Please stop me, sweetheart.
Okay, honey, it's...
I'm sorry, sweetheart. Yes.
So this is a no, right?
No, it's a yes.
So Tatiana moves on. And with her is Jackie Migdiff, Cody Sheldon, Matt Breetsky, Juno Joyner, Nick Mitchell, Amory Boscovich, Felicia Barton, and TK Hash. The judges' decisions are cast and the long wait is over. And as the three winning rooms meet in the hallway, their celebration continues. But like the end of every Hollywood results day, it's filled with both joy and sorrow.
Not everybody gave their best performance tonight. Some people were going to go home, myself included.
You didn't think you were going to make it, but you did.
This is my comeback this year.
Mom, I made it. I made it.
I just made it.
Tomorrow night on American Idol, they've made it through the toughest week of their lives, but they're not there yet. The judges have reviewed the tapes, and now it's time to reveal the final 36. That means the remaining contestants will have to face the judges one last time at the judges' mansion. They'll sit in a hot seat to find out if they have cause to celebrate.
You made it, baby.
Congratulations. Welcome to season 8.
Or a reason to grieve.
It's not good news.
It isn't?
You wouldn't have won anyway.
You didn't make it, dog.
Are you kidding me?
No!
And this year, we've added a twist.
Sing for your survival now.
When I wake up in the morning and see you next to me.
It all happens tomorrow night at 8.
This is not the way I wanted it to be.